Mandazi Chama Road, going to Chama for a screening. 80% of our journey is done. We moved from Lusaka to Chipata, Lundazi. Now we are going to Chama. But as you can see, the bridge here has been washed away by the rains. So the community have improvised a temporary bridge. We have been here for an hour. Literally, there was nothing. The bridge was all washed away and there was nothing that remained. As you know that Miriam is the young girl who was attacked in 2018 in Chama district. She was attacked and her right hand was chopped off for ritual purposes. Up to now, the case has not gone to court. I've just been asking them how far the case has been. There have been about 5 people have been arrested, including a teacher from the same village, that's Chikwa village. And unfortunately, the case has not gone to court. So we are still waiting to see what's happening. And we try to check on the police to ask them why has the case taken so long to go to court. I also checked on Miriam to find out what are the challenges that she has been facing. How has life been since she was attacked? And she told me she has been having troubles with, you know, doing house chores, things like washing, cooking. She can't go to the farm to cultivate. Those are some of the challenges she has been facing since the attack, because now she has lost one hand. And about school, she said she cannot go back to school because she cannot write with the left hand. However, she said if there is anything that she can do with one hand, she'll be able to do that. So I think it's a matter of rehabilitation. She needs to be rehabilitated and to see what kind of skills that she can have. And also, just checking on the situation, she says she's still living in fear. She still think about the attack, and when it is at night, she fears to walk around, so the trauma still come back to her mind. Those are some of the things that it's happening right now. So So we check on her, and as an organization, we keep on following up these cases. What we want to see is an environment where people with albinism should enjoy their human rights like anyone else. Umaganiza bwanji bali baje bamene baraku start attack. Umabaganiza apo. Ungafune boma ya bachi tapochani.
Baba kome aga kukuku.
Mpwenzi omila kwa. Alukumba kuzwaona na mmesa.
Kwa koma ka? Kuchoka paja pa mine vinashitikira. Uma, pa umangara buwanji.
Panyaga nukumbuka. Panyaga nundu wako. Songa tukwa fipa zamani kwa nukumbuka.
Ungabauze buwanji maubino zivanzako. Pamene sivazi wa pamene vishitika kuti bantu wako uma.
Ni afunde.
Ngawaze kubwanji maubino zivanzako. Paja ubwere unakamba tsikuru sunga pitirize chifukwa sunga limbire ku left.
Nukwane chani.
So manje maplanizi yako uzafuna uchita chani moyo wako. Unagali zapo buwanji. Mwene ufuna uchita, wamuzambu, nkara buwanji, o kapina kulinchito, o unagali za buwanji.
Nchito inyanga, nipasa kwa iwe uyoti kwa nishana wako imoza kusewe.
Hapa manjo kwa nisa buwanji, kumkala na kwanza imozi. Mavuto buwanji maina upeza.
Kuwasha, na upika. Usamba nusaka basi kuwako kumbuta kwa waka. Kulimu.
Yeah, so Miriam was 4 months pregnant, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Was 3 months pregnant the time she was attacked.
Mm-hmm.
That was in 2018. However, she didn't lose the pregnancy, and she came to Lusaka for some time, and she gave birth to a healthy baby girl, Marumbo. So, apa manda inazaka zingatima?
1 year 9.
Akura, akura. So we thank God that the child was not lost during the attack, and this is the child, firstborn child for Miriam. Kuna taxi. What do I have win also?
We want to see the actual place
where Miriam was taken and where she was attacked from.
Kumatingo pemba boma kuti ibwepo kuti anthu tangaso kujwa munthu ayanga na manja ni chinthu chimozi chopesa chisoro.
Then they were sleeping in the night inside their home. Then they came three people, as per what she mentioned. They knocked at the door, shouting at the name of the husband, like they wanted water in the night. Then this man opened the door. When the wife and the small child that I'm keeping myself at my house currently, he's at my home. His name is Musa Nyirongo. I keep him, and I started keeping the boy when he was 8 months old, after the mother was killed, was an albino. After the husband opened the door, they asked him, and he fell down fainted. They entered the house. When they entered the house, they grabbed the woman who was albino. They asked her, and there was a big fight where they were asking her. Currently, the case is still in the hands of the police, and I believe the OP and the health officers are still looking into the matter. The woman is Charit Zimba Nyirongo.
Chuma chiri muntaka. So John Chit manje mche provision yopereka mbeo kubalimi. Wazilima
nenda. Oka tijizoo na pima chitika. Mena mkumuka niza kwanji. Nizoo na kuti malo ya pati upia upinu ya angalemi ya semu ntu. Hapa wale kambatia. Wale kambatia ya mwale. Papa seta, wale kambatia ya. Mena mkumuka wakambatiki machitika.
Because I say much thicker. Because is that the same like us black people?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, but you know what I'm saying now. Who can now look for me? I'm much thicker.
In food, you put that we are a guy, I'm a little different than two guys. I'm not a guy, I'm a little bit of a guy. I'm a little bit of a guy.
Tuta verabuenu mwema bolera kono tapunzi ila vambiri mweta punzi ila tendo punza kwa na wena ngugunyumba watu wazibe maobino na wewe ni wandu mwonga isi zikomo
watoto reni koni hawa tapunzi ila kwa kuti maobino zina wewe ni wandu sima mene ele waka kupeza tuwa gwira ubino ni mulandu ukuru maningi muziba so ni mulandu ukuru so ivivo gwira maubino kuti hawe wazare tiremere ni mulandu ukuru. Musakame kuti sinazibe, raswa itabwela, tamila ngiza huku. Maubino ziniwa ntu naweza hii? Maubino ziniwa ndani? Niwa ntu. Mwanitisi ya na wabati, sisi nisewa ntu naise? Mwaona ka? Hela pamufula ni mimbia no mimbia maona, bati ndina ubino maona ka? Bati niza mimbia mwivele na bwino, mtine muntu naise? Sima me?
Sare quel cibo.